Privilege to me to be here. My name is Ken Harris. I'm the Member of Parliament for Calgary Centre and the Minister of Sport and Persons with Disabilities. And I'm so proud of you all for coming to get together on a Saturday afternoon to discuss issues of importance to not only the Muslim community, but to this great city, province, and in fact, this country. We have had many trials and tribulations over the course of our long history, and I'm reminded that we tend to often blame the last person off a boat or a plane for all of our troubles. I'm reminded that in 1838, there were many Irish people fleeing from famine, and they came to Canada. And if you read the Toronto newspapers around that time, there were descriptions of who are these vile Irish coming to our shores with their strange religious practices. They are lazy. They don't take part in the community. They want to hang out amongst themselves. My goodness, they're going to be the death of Canada. Fast forward. Here we are, a long time into the future, where you think we'd be better than that. And in many ways we are. In many, many ways we are. But yet, too many times you hear, whether you're going down the street, whether you're at a mosque, whether you're trying to order a sandwich at Tim Hortons, people have fundamental misconceptions about people, about other religions, about the other person that they don't know. And that is one of those things we have to do better at and call it out. I was amazed by your statistics. 51% of people of Islamic faith felt they'd been discriminated against in the last year. That's far, far too much. That's far too much. Where we have to do better. And I know that what breaks down these stereotypes, what breaks down this type of hate and intolerance is context. You know what doesn't survive? Racism doesn't survive context. Where you get to know a person, where you get to see them and establish a relationship. So as we discussed here, I encourage you all to reach out to both the tolerant and intolerant alike. And I know that's not easy to try and be able to do that. But your leadership here today and expressing that shows that you are committed to reducing this friction, reducing what is happening in our society. Canada has a lot to be proud of. Well, we're as our sesquicentennial, our 150th birthday. Right? We do have much to be proud of in this country. We have a Charter of Rights and Freedoms that protects minority rights, languages, and gives us an ability to have those protections that we deem to be so valuable. Okay? We also have, I believe, the most fundamental thing we are proud of is the fact we are a multicultural country. And that should be celebrated more than it is. And I know our Prime Minister enforces that each and every day when we're in Ottawa throughout this country. We have so many different groups of people who have contributed to Canada's success, because the only people who, everyone here is an immigrant, except for our Indigenous brothers and sisters who have been building communities here in this country for generation upon generation upon generation. We have all just come here. We've built something special, something we should be proud of. But that doesn't mean that we can stand to the side. We have to keep battling, keep going forward. And I know we have people in this room who are doing just that. And then so on behalf of the Prime Minister of this great nation, Justin Trudeau, I want to thank you all for doing what you're doing, for being leaders in your community, for being valued participants. And I know he always says, diversity makes us stronger. That is what we truly believe and have in Daniel. I can also say, many people say when they come here, they think they're lucky to be there, either. Maybe. But I think there's another way that I, as a Canadian, think about this. We're lucky to have you. All of you. Okay? Whoever comes to this nation to build a life, we have to be thankful for. Because it really does allow us to be that country that people aspire to, that people look at from afar, that people say, my goodness, that is a place of welcome, which we need to continue it to be. Thank you so much.